Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn about how ratios can be used in geometric figures. Let's get started. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to simplify ratios and apply them to solve for unknown values in geometric figures. First, we'll explore what a ratio is and how to simplify ratios. Then we'll complete two example problems using ratios to solve for angle measures and side lengths. Finally, you'll have a chance to explore additional practice and real-life applications in your notes template. So, what is a ratio? A ratio is a comparison of amounts in relation to each other. You probably already use ratios every day without even knowing it. For example, a lot of people have pet dogs. Dog owners use a ratio to know how much to feed their dogs. Let's say the ratio of the amount of food to the weight of the dog is half of a cup for every 10 pounds that the dog weighs. So, if a dog weighs 20 pounds, how much food do you think she should be fed? Multiplying the weight in our given ratio times 2 gives us the weight of the dog. So, we can also multiply the cups of food times the same number, 2, and see that she should eat 1 cup of food. What if you know that the amount of food the dog eats is 3.5 cups, and you calculate the weight of the dog? Well, to get from 0.5 to 3.5, we multiply by 7, so we have to use the same number to multiply by the weight, so 10 times 7, to give us 70 pounds. Therefore, 3.5 cups of food would be the recommended amount of food for a 70-pound dog. Ratios will be very important in geometry, too. We're going to need to be comfortable working with ratios for future lessons in this unit. So let's look at a more geometric explanation of what a ratio is. We can use ratios to compare side lengths, like in this triangle. We could say that the ratio of these sides, from the least to the greatest, is 6 to 9 to 12. You don't necessarily have to write your ratio from least to greatest, but I figured it would make this example more clear. Anyways, we can simplify this ratio by finding a factor that all these numbers have in common. What's the greatest common factor of 6, 9, and 12? Or in other words, what's the biggest whole number that we can divide all of these by and still get non-decimal answers? We can divide them all by 3, and when we do that, we still get whole numbers. 6 divided by 3 is 2. 9 divided by 3 is 3, and 12 divided by 3 is 4. Did you notice that in our dog food example, our ratio had a decimal in it? 0.5 cups of dog food for every 10 pounds of weight? Many times in real day-to-day uses of ratios, we do have decimals in our ratios. In the dog food example, it makes sense to have the ratio simplified like that because it makes it easier for people with small dogs to calculate a serving size. But when you're working with ratios in geometry, it's considered proper grammar to use the smallest whole numbers possible. Also, the simplified ratio is always the best answer to provide for someone else. Using smaller numbers makes ratios easier to work with, so let's get rid of the unsimplified ratio that we started with here. Let's look at another triangle. Can you set up the ratio for this triangle? Go ahead and write the ratio from least to greatest, so we all have the same answers. Are you able to simplify your ratio now by dividing the numbers by a greatest common factor? Here's the ratio before it's simplified. And here it is after dividing all three numbers by the greatest common factor of 2. Let's do one more example. Can you write a ratio for this triangle from least to greatest and then simplify it as much as possible? Don't let this question confuse you. The ratio you probably wrote down right away is the best answer for this. If we tried to divide these three numbers by something, like 2 for example, we would end up with decimals in our ratio. Remember, it's best to avoid decimals in ratios in geometry, since it isn't nice math grammar and it can make the ratios more difficult to work with, even though in our other daily situations, decimals do appear in ratios, like in that dog food example. Now, did you notice anything about all three of the triangles we've looked at so far? Let's look at them all again. And the ratios that we found for all of them. The simplified ratios match. Having the same ratio is going to be super important in upcoming lessons because it tells us that the sides of these triangles have the same relationship as each other. For example, this side is twice as big as this side. And that's true in all of these triangles because they all have the same ratio. Notice that a ratio doesn't necessarily tell us the exact side length of each of these triangles. It just tells us how the side lengths compare to each other. For the triangle we were just working with, we would multiply the numbers in the ratio by 1 to see the side lengths of this triangle. In the middle triangle, we would need to multiply the numbers in the ratio by 2 to get its side lengths. And in the triangle farthest to the left, can you figure out how our ratio relates to the side lengths? That's right, we can multiply the numbers in the ratio times 3. The fact that the ratio tells us how the sides relate to each other, but not necessarily the exact measurements for the lengths, is going to be very important in this unit. So, now that we know how ratios are calculated, and that many figures can have the same simplified ratio, let's apply this knowledge to solve some problems. Here's our first example problem. It says, the perimeter of a rectangle is 120 units, and the ratio of the length to the width is 7 to 5. Find the length and width of the rectangle. You can see here that a ratio only has two numbers, and that's all we need. Since the perimeter of a figure means the sum of all of its sides, we can draw a picture for this problem to help us visualize all of them. We might be tempted to say that both sides representing the length are 7 units, and both sides representing the width are 5 units, but 7 plus 5 plus 7 plus 5 would not give us 120. What if we multiplied these by 2? Then they would say 14, 10, 14, 10. Since we multiplied all the side lengths by the same value of 2, it is true that these sides still have the same ratio. But do these sides add up to 120? No. I could try multiplying them times 3, or 3.5, or 4, and then just see if they add up to 120, but that would be guessing and checking, and we know that's not a very efficient way to solve problems. So instead, we have to think of this ratio as a comparison between the sides. Just like when we explored this ratio concept with the three triangles earlier. These sides would be 7 times some number x, and then these sides would be 5 times that same number. Now all we have to do is figure out what that number is. Can you set up an equation that involves adding the sides up and setting them equal to the perimeter of 120? We know that all four sides of this rectangle add up to equal a perimeter of 120 units. So let's add them together and set it equal to 120. Pause the video now and solve this for x. Then go back to the original question and see if you can answer it. Let's see how it went. First, we need to combine like terms on the left. Then we can divide by 24 to get that x is 5. Did the original question ask us to find x? No, we were asked to find the length and width. So let's take our x value of 5 and substitute it in to see what each side length is. 7 times 5 gives us 35, and 5 times 5 gives us 25. Let's double check our work here. Do these four side lengths add up to 120 like they're supposed to? Yes, they do. Now, do you remember which of these is the length and which is the width? It's easy to forget, but we can go back to our original problem to figure it out. In the description, did you notice that it says length before width? The ratio is written in the same order as the description, so this would also be the length before the width. Since 7 is bigger than 5, the length is the bigger of the sides, so let's look back at our drawing. Which measurement is the length, and which is the width? The length is the bigger side, making it 35 units, and the width is 25 units. And that's our final answer. Here's one more example problem. This says the ratio of the angles in a triangle is 2 to 3 to 4. What's the measure of each angle? Do you have some ideas on how to solve this? This doesn't tell us the perimeter like the last problem did, but this does tell us that we're working with the angles in a triangle. What do the interior angles of a triangle add up to? 180 degrees. I bet we're going to be creating an equation with 180 in it. See if you can figure this problem out. Start by drawing a picture and setting up an equation. Then see if you can find the final answer. Pause the video now so you can try this yourself. Did you draw a triangle and then label the angles using the ratio? Since we don't have any other information about this triangle, we could put these labels in any angle we want. Now that you have a visual, do you see how we could represent this with an equation that includes 180? If you got stuck here, pause the video again and try to set up and solve an equation to find x. All three angle measures will add up to 180 degrees. Then we can combine like terms and divide by 9 to get our final x value. Now we can substitute this x value back into each expression to get our angle measures. This gives us 40, 60, and 80 degrees as our angle measures. Do these add up to 180 like they're supposed to? Yes, they do. Great. Let's write this as our final answer. Now you can simplify ratios and apply ratios to solve for unknown values in geometric figures. There's a little more practice in your notes template and a practice game for you to work through. This will help to make sure that you're confident in what you've learned before you move on to the next lesson. It's been fun, and I will see you next time.